As we close out this year and move into a new one, I thought I'd share with you some amazing resources for elementary math that are free. I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and today we're going to take a look at my favorite free elementary math resources as we work to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Now, I'm a firm believer in the phrase, you get what you pay for, meaning that if something is cheap, it's usually cheaply made. Case in point, I was scrolling through Instagram and saw this cute dress, saw that it was only $15, but I was like, it's so cute on that model. I'm sure it's going to be just fine when it arrives. Well, then it shows up and it's the same material as in the picture, but not the same dress. Here it is, and it's just like a big box, basically. There is no shape to it whatsoever, and it looks like just a big bag on me. Have you ever had that happen? Where you buy something and it was cheap, and you get it, and it's not quite what you thought it was going to be. Now, the same can be true for a lot of educational resources, but there are also some gems out there that are amazing, powerful resources, yet also free. So that's what I thought I'd share with you today are my top three favorite free resources that are also amazing. So here we go. Number one is Steve Wyborney. Now I know you've, but if you've been around with me at any point in time, you know I love Steve, but what he's been doing here lately makes me love him even more. On Steve's site, he has a ton of resources, but the one that I really want to highlight is back on November 1st, Steve decided he was going to spend his time putting together a resource for you to use every single school day. So he's taken a break for holidays, but any school day, he has created a number sense routine for you to use. And this page is full of it. I don't know if you can see, but you know, off to the side where it shows my scrolling, there's a long ways to go down this page. He, since November 1st, has created a new resource for you guys to use to help build number sense. Did you hear the dog? To help build number sense in this trying time of education. So I know you may be familiar with Steve's resources, but if you have not seen what he is putting out every single day, then I want you to go take a look at that. And you can start from today's date, or you can start using things that he has previously made on those days. And they are just something that you can use instantly. I love Steve's resources. If you're not familiar with them, this page is a great place to get familiar with his resources. So take a look at Steve's page where he is putting a new resource every single day. So if you need a number sense routine, this page you can go to and you know that there's going to be something that you can use and not have to make yourself. Now up next is Greg Tang. Yes, like the drink, that's how you spell it. But don't forget, all the links to any of these resources that I'm sharing are down below this video. If you're watching this video somewhere else, come over to the main page that's linked up with this video, and that's where you can find all of the links to the resources. So Greg Tang has a ton of great resources and games on his website, but there's one certain area that I want to draw your attention to on his site. So when you go to gregtangmath.com, it looks like this. And again, there's tons of stuff here. There's games, there's PD stuff on here, but the one I really wanted to highlight are his books. I love Greg Tang's books. And if you are teaching remotely, sharing books can be somewhat difficult right now. Even if you're not remotely, this is a great place because then you don't have to order the book. But if you click on any one of his books here, I'm just going to click on Math for All Seasons. It brings up the pages of the book. And I could even zoom in on this particular area, just that area, so that that's all that my students are seeing when I do a screen share. And we can talk about the poem, figure out how many tulips there are, and put in the answer that we come up with and see. And then you can go through all of the poems that are in that book. Now, if you want to buy the book, there is a link to buy the book there, but the books are available for free right there that you guys could use and do them either in person or remotely right away, and it's all for free right there on his website. Okay, my third and final free resource I'm going to share with you is teresawills.com. Now, on her page, she has a ton of resources just like the other two that I've shared with you, but the one I want to direct your attention to is this one where it is math routines for remote learning. Now, Teresa kind of has built a name for herself around the templates that she has created for remote learning, but the ones that I really wanted to share with you are these ones that are specific to number sense routines. And the cool part is on this page, she has a lot of them where you get to watch the routine in a remote classroom. She has a quick little video that shows the routine in 20 seconds. So if you've ever done the routine in your own classroom, like in person, you know what the routine's about. And so watching this quick little 20-second video is kind of nice. But if you've never done like an open middle before and you're not quite sure what it is, what it looks like, then that's where where you can watch the whole routine in a classroom is really helpful. So she always links to other places too, like this open middle. There's a whole website of open middle resources, which is another great free resource as well. But I love these templates that she has created to go along with some fabulous resources that are out there. So Teresa Wills has tons of fabulous templates that you can use, but her site is full of info about using the templates to help you do these in a remote setting, especially number sense routines, which can be difficult in a remote setting because it's hard to get kids engaged and sharing their thinking. That is for sure. That's one of the hardest things to do. And these templates will help you be able to navigate that and make it a little bit easier to do. So again, these are just my top three right now because I think they are so relevant, so useful that you can just take them, use them in your class right away, whether you are in person or remote. So I'm sure that I've missed some and that maybe you've got a top one that I don't have here. So in the comments, let me know what that is. Tell me your favorite resource for elementary math that is free that people can go and start using right away. Well, I hope this video will help you get out there and build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.